sandhill cranes have an average population between 2 to 5,000 that live in Florida year-round. However, during the winter months, a lot of cranes come from the Great Lake region for migration from the cold weather. Here in Spring Hill, however, it is a non-breeding ground area for sandhill cranes. Sandhill cranes are most closely related to another type of crane known as the whooping crane, is slowly being reintroduced to North America as it is on the endangered list. There is a big similarity between the facial features and the color on their faces. The average weight of a sandhill crane is between 7 to 10 pounds, making them much lighter than people would expect. The average height of a sandhill crane is between 3 and 3.5 feet. Almost a foot of that is just their neck alone. Sandhill wingspans can reach between 5 and 6 feet, and the largest one ever recorded was almost 7 feet long. In the entire world, there's only approximately 2,800 people that are over 7 feet tall, which equates to about 0.00038% of the people in the entire world being over 7 feet tall. Sandhill cranes have one of the most unique calls of all the types of cranes around the entire planet. Sandhill cranes are able to emit these noises due to their enlarged tracheas that they have. Their calls can be heard up to an incredible 2.5 miles away, as well as their other noises such as moans, hissing, goose-like honks, and other snorting sounds. Pop quiz. Which of these birds is not a type of crane? A. Heron. B. Sandhill. C. Flamingo. D. Grouse. The answer is A. Herons. Herons fly with their neck bent and their head tucked in, so it appears they have a shorter neck with long trailing legs. The crane, however, flies with the neck outstretched like a goose, but also trails its long legs behind. Sandhill cranes usually feed in small marshes, where they have a choice of seeds, nuts, and small insects. Sandhills also often choose to create their nests in shallow water, in which they end up being about 5 feet in diameter on average. The eggs that sandhill cranes produce take about 29 to 32 days for hatching. This shows another similarity between the whooping crane and the sandhill crane, both of which take the same amount of time for their eggs to hatch. Of the 15 different types of sandhill crane species, 6 of them are considered endangered or critically endangered. Of all the different types of cranes, sandhill cranes have some of the most unique ways of attracting mate. They do things such as dancing, bobbing their head, and flapping their wings to try to attract mates. In addition to the head bobbing and dancing, they use assorted calls and screeches to attract mates as well. If you have any questions on sandhill cranes or cranes in general, please feel free to comment below and ask us any questions about anything. This has been Cranes with the Canes. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.